I know that I told you today that I was going to show you the new camera, unbox it, test it, all that good stuff, but I changed my mind. You see, today is Friday the 13th. Right here behind me, this is where they filmed Friday the 13th Part 7. This is Camp Crystal Lake. On Friday, May the 13th of 1988, Friday the 13th, Part 7, The New Blood was released. The entire movie was shot and filmed in Bay Minette, Alabama, right here where I'm standing. This is Burns Lake, right here behind me. The iconic dock from the movie, they have tore down and replaced it. There is nothing standing left from the cabin that was right off to the side of the lake. They blew it up at the end of the movie, and they blew it up for real at the end of the movie. But all the locations where Jason murdered someone is still right here. I had plans, like I told you, to show you the new camera, which I am filming on right now, but I will show you the unboxing, show you what kind of camera it is we got and all that tomorrow. I myself didn't pay attention that Friday the 13th was coming up. It looks a lot different than what it did in the movie now that they have redone a lot of it. For example, this is the dock now. And this is the dock from the movie.
I think it was my fault.
If I did not know this is where it was filmed at, I would never be able to recognize it. But I will tell you, Adam the Woo has been here, and I'll show you what it looked like when he visited. As you can tell, they changed it up quite a bit. It was the concrete slab was right here. This is brand new. They have obviously just poured this concrete, and then the dock or pier was right there, but it had a ramp that it sloped down and then went out. Now they have converted it into what you see right there. It's under construction right now. I actually had to park my car about half a mile back and walk in to this, and that's because they had it blocked off for construction access. They're not working on it today, so I parked my car up there and walked around their barrels to get down here to be able to get these shots. The whole lake centered around this road coming in right here. This road led right up to the dock. There was also, they built a cabin on the left, and they built a cabin on the right for the movie.
There he is. I think you'd be waiting too long.
No, I really like it up here. Did you have a good trip?
Oh, it was a very nice drive.
Those cabins were never here in real life. They were only constructed just for Friday the 13th, The New Blood. In the movie, there is a scene where they come up and you can see the cabin right over this way, and there's a blue van sitting right out front. Right behind the blue van, you can see this storm drain right there. It has another concrete layer that was built up on top of it, but you can still see the storm drain. The blue van would have been right in here, and then the cabin was right over here.
I rest my case.
house facade right here, maybe part of it. What do you think?
There is shots in the movie from this angle here where you can see the other cabin, what it was right over here. They had like a blue Caprice car parked over here and a Jeep over that way. Those shots would have been taken from right here, and you can actually see this tree here in that shot. You can see the water bubbling up from right here at this angle. The trees had a lot less leaves on it when they filmed it. Obviously, they filmed it during fall, because there was no green on the trees there in the background. But that's the shot. You can even see the reflection in the water, just like you can in the movie.
We used to come up.
As you can see here behind me, the road coming into the property, they have it blocked off for construction, I guess, where they're rebuilding the pier. You would think with the Friday the 13th coming up, they would have left it open with people knowing that this is where Friday the 13th Part 7 was filmed. But no, they were definitely not prepared for that. What made this Part 7 more interesting is they had the girl with telekinetic powers, which is just something they hadn't done before. And that added a different element. And she was able to combat Jason using her telekinesis. And that was kind of interesting. We are up the driveway, just around the corner from the boat ramp. Right here is where they placed the sign that said Crystal Lake, 5 miles. Of course, it's nowhere near 5 miles away, but they placed the sign right here so they could film the shot of the actors walking past the sign.
Some birthday.
It's gonna be a great birthday, Thomas.
Of course, the main scenes in the houses were filmed inside the houses, and those houses were blown up in the movie, like I said. They pretty much shot that entire movie within just very little room right around the edge of Burns Lake here. They didn't really have to go that far away from where the dock is to film it. In fact, this area where it's kind of cleared out right here, this is where he killed the people who were in their tents. All that right here.
I'm cold.
Why don't we crawl in the sack?
Why don't you fix the fire?
There's no wood.
We're in a forest.
There's one scene where there's a girl out in the water swimming. She looks up to see Jason killing the guy up here on the land, and then he goes down the edge into the water.
You need a formal invitation?
They used all of these trails that have been cut out or made by people walking through them. They used those to get around and to film the wood scenes where he murders people in the wood. I was hoping that the pier was still here so I could witness it myself, so I could see it with my own two eyes. Part of cinema history. And it sucks that they've taken it out and are now replacing it with this new pier here. But it was there for a long time. For many, many, many years that pier stood. So undoubtedly it would have had to been replaced at some time. Where the new pier is at here is actually really pretty much the same spot that the old one was in. It's not much different. In the movie it had the awning that covered the pier, but it didn't have all of this area. In fact, right here, right in this area here, this is where the little girl drives the boat up and it falls apart on top of her dad. That would have happened right here where they now have this deck built at. Of course, the cabins, they were blown up there at the end. The girl had the telekinetic powers. She set Jason on fire. She also crashed the porch roof on top of him at one point. Unfortunately, there's nothing left. You would never know that they filmed it down here if you didn't know. This is a pretty interesting addition to the Friday the 13th franchise. That is it for the filming locations for the 1988 slasher scary movie, Friday the 13th, Part 7, The New Blood. I will include a link in my description below to Adam the Woo's video. So if you want to go see what he had to say about this place, you can. I want to thank you all for watching. We're still in Mobile for tomorrow. I will tomorrow explain and show you this new camera that we're filming on today. And I'll see you again tomorrow. I hope you have a great day.
Friday the 13th, Part 7, The New Blood.
Goes the neighborhood.